Hello, and it's a pleasure to welcome everyone. My name is Susan Fox. I'm the chair of the Westchester County Association and president and CEO of White Plains Hospital. It's so exciting to welcome everyone here to our 2024 leadership event. It's always a very special event for us. It's a little bit different this year, right? We're not at the Marriott. It's not pouring rain. We had different challenges tonight, but we will learn from them. So I hope everybody didn't have too much trouble getting here. And we're glad that you're seated and hopefully have at least one drink on board. And we have a very exciting, lovely evening in celebration of some amazing people that are in our community doing great things. So thank you all for joining us. I know that we had some special visitors as well. Am I echoing? Oh, okay, just me. Okay. We had some special visitors a little bit earlier. I don't know if they're still here. New York State Senator Shelley Mayer was here a little bit earlier. Shelley, I'm assuming you're not here anymore, but thank you for coming. And Assemblyman Steve Otis was here as well. And yes, I think that they came and went, so hopefully we gave them a nice warm welcome. They are always here for us, so we're really appreciative that they got to stop by and spend a few minutes with us. Also, representatives of Senators Schumer and Gillibrand are here tonight. I didn't get introduced to you, but if you're here, you can wave or stand and, okay. We'll give you credit too, even if you're not here, okay. So again, tonight's event recognizes leaders in our community, and while there are many ways to demonstrate leadership, what I think is universal is that leaders inspire and motivate others to turn a shared vision into a reality. And that is what we do at the Westchester County Association. We turn big ideas into action. And this year, there were many accomplishments across all of our key strategic areas, and I just wanted to note a few. One, we held our first ever Hudson Valley Digital Innovation Conference to pave the way for a more inclusive digital landscape. Two, we added a total of $1.25 million in grants in support of the community-based Y-Zone program and Connect Westchester to help make digital connectivity more accessible. We created new and innovative workforce programs that helped 180 candidates land their new jobs and provided hundreds of other individuals with new marketable skills. Amazing. Through our advocacy efforts, we helped restore $1 billion in Medicaid cuts. That's challenging, but our elected officials are trying to help there, and we appreciate that. And lastly, just to highlight, we also moved our sustainability efforts forward by developing an innovative policy playbook to support the transition to a green economy. That was pretty good. These are just a few examples of our accomplishments. You can check out some of the boards in the hallway, which highlight some of this work. We're also going to show a short video, which highlights this work and is really very exciting when we see it all come together, and we should all feel really good about that. This year also, the WCA experienced growth in our membership with nearly 24 more members. Welcome to all of you who are new. We look forward to getting to know you. Thank you for being here. And we encourage you to be on one of our strategic committees and get involved. And speaking of committees, there is some incredible work happening there. And I want to thank all of our members that participate in our committees and also would like to call out our leaders who spend extra time with the staff making sure that we have a very aggressive agenda that we follow and enables us to stand here year after year and talk about what we've been able to accomplish together. So first I'd like to ask Chris Fisher and Robin White for chairing our digital committee. If you could just stand and we'll thank you. I don't think I saw Derek Anderson, who is the CEO at Northern West. Derek, you're here. Yay. Say hi. CEO at Northern Westchester for chairing our healthcare committee. I know I did see Bill Cuddy here, I think, who has chaired our real estate committee year after year. Thank you, Bill, for your leadership. I definitely saw Mary D'Amato, and I don't know if I saw Ali Federico. Thank you both for, yep, they're here, for chairing our workforce. And I did see Ashish Arora. Thank you so much for chairing our newest committee, our sustainability committee. Thank you, Ashish. So for those of you in the room, I know that you know that driving change is really a team sport. And impact happens when many people come together, which we have demonstrated. But it also requires talented and dedicated leadership. And I want to also turn to my left and thank WCA President Michael Romita for his work, his leadership. And I know Michael's going to call out the incredible staff that work every day in support of all the work that we do. So Michael, thank you. And ultimately, to the board of directors, thank you all for being here. Thank you for your support. And again, hopefully everyone feels really good about what we're able to accomplish together. Thank you for the board. Tonight, we will recognize four extraordinary leaders with awards for their work in helping lead the way in meeting clean energy goals, bringing affordable housing to the region, advancing smart growth and sustainable development, and advancing digital equity. Congratulations in advance to Justin Driscoll, who I just met, Jonathan Gertman, John Nolan, and Meg Glander. We'll hear a lot more about them in a few minutes, but you have all accomplished so much, and we are thrilled to be able to highlight those accomplishments and congratulate you, and thank you for all of your contributions to the county. Yes. And I did miss Mayor Roach is here from White Plains. So thank you, Tom, for being there and showing up all the time and being in White Plains. I definitely feel that support. So I appreciate you being here tonight. And in your program also, unfortunately, George Latimer is not able to be here. Even though his term has a few more weeks, he's already busy in Washington. So we're so proud of him, and we're so excited to see his leadership on a broader scale. And maybe we can just give a little bit of an applause for all that he's done for us. And wish him luck, because we're going to need it. Okay. That didn't mean anything. So in closing, thank you again for all being here tonight. I look forward, and I know you all do. There was a lot of socializing going on. As you know, we get to do this, have our formal part, but look forward to the informal part, which is our cocktail hour, and look forward to saying hello to each of you. So thank you all for being here again. And my pleasure to introduce Michael Romita.
Thank you very much, Susan. Susan always makes a point of thanking the board and the leaders of our committees. She, of course, leaves herself out. So I want to recognize Susan and all of the work that she does with us. You cannot do this work unless you have an active board led by someone who cares deeply about that work. And boy, if you want to work with Susan, you need to be on your game. I also want to thank the many sponsors tonight. Thank you for believing in our mission and supporting tonight's event. And of course, I want to thank our staff, not just for tonight, but for all of the work they do behind the scenes with the symposiums and the committee meetings and all of the different working groups. We have a great staff, and they really make it happen. So Amy, Jason, Melissa, Kathy, Jill, and Kelly, please stand quickly, and hopefully everybody will give you a round of applause. And if you see them and talk to them later on, please buy them a drink. I'm kidding, the drinks are free in the Rana, so. At this point, I just want to introduce the sizzle video that we play every year to talk about last year's accomplishments, and then I'll take it from there. So Joe, cue the video, and let's get started.
At its core, the WCA is an ideation machine. It's a place where professionals across the spectrum come together to talk about and try and solve the biggest issues that face the regional economy, all working together to solve these issues.
When we bring all of this renewable energy into New York City, it has ripple effects across the state's entire grid.
This document is here for us. It's here for our planners and municipal officials. It's a resource guide. It's white paper.
There are always continuing challenges. They don't kind of come and go. So whether it's affordable housing for young people who grew up here in the county and are challenged to find places to live and stay in the county.
This year, we launched Welcome Home Westchester, our 5 in 25 initiatives. 5 practical steps that every town, village, and municipality in Westchester can take in order to get the kind of affordable housing we need built. Why is housing so important? When I talk to business leaders across the spectrum, the fundamental issue that they all face is access to workforce and talent.
You know, WCA is a critical ingredient in how the county does workforce development and economic development, which are obviously very connected. At Mercy University, obviously we're training students. We're hoping that they will be successful in navigating the workforce.
Last year, the WCA launched the 1,000 Jobs Challenge. 1,000 local jobs, $50+ million of repeatable annual economic impact coming back into Westchester.
One of the projects that WCA spearheaded is a talent pipeline effort that works to train certain healthcare workers and place them in jobs.
1 in 5 New Yorkers by 2040 will be over the age of 65. Healthcare remains so vital to our economy.
The younger generations have a different outlook on the medical field because once they hear about the medical field, they think doctors, nurses, surgeons, but they really bypass the EMT and paramedic stage. And with the WCA, we've been working with doing job fairs and, you know, working into the recruitment side of things.
To date, these programs have trained 325 potential healthcare workers, and our area healthcare employers, including many in this room, have already hired 190 highly qualified program graduates, and there's more coming through the pipeline, so stay tuned.
We have a robust community of thinkers and doers.
So this year we focused in the healthcare space a lot on reimbursement issues. A lot of the providers, not just hospitals, but the providers across the entire healthcare spectrum are facing funding issues, really resulting from compounding effects of COVID.
Having high-speed access strengthens community. It gives them options to actually participate.
Westchester County Association has been working on this issue for a decade. This day is really the culmination of a lot of different efforts dating back to Gigabit Westchester, Y-Zone, Connect Westchester, and all of our partners, including county government and the business community. It's really to connect people with hospitals, banking, their own communities and their own governments. What that really means for Westchester on the ground is economic growth.
We also created the region's first and only business sustainability conference called Profit and Purpose that we hold at Pace Law School every year. And that brings together hundreds of the region's leading experts on climate change and sustainability.
The WCA is really great about keeping important issues and updates about these issues at the forefront of everybody's mind.
I work with WCA in a number of different capacities. I'm on the real estate task force with them. I attend those meetings, and then I also am a member of the new leaders group.
So we want to make sure that the county thrives economically, that there are good jobs that will attract young folks who are graduating colleges to come and work here, and that they can find affordable housing so it makes sense to come and live and set down roots in their backyards where they're working and growing their own careers.
It's ideation to activation. That's the difference maker. Next year is the Westchester County Association's 75th anniversary, and I can't wait to see what happens next.
Well, most of you know that it always rains the night of our event. So to add to all of these great accomplishments over the last year, later on this evening, we shall be bringing rain back to Westchester at some point. At the end of the video, it mentioned that next year's our diamond anniversary, and it's going to be a year of reflection and celebration. We already have an ad hoc anniversary committee pulled together. They've embarked down the endless rabbit hole of choosing a anniversary style logo. And I think we're, Dawn, are we close to a logo? We're close to a logo, okay. So we're getting there. And we're planning some special things to celebrate our strong history and legacy of accomplishment. But we won't just be sitting on the past. We'll be building on it and moving forward with our mission for the future. And for Westchester next year, that means hundreds more people placed into high demand jobs with our local employers. It means thousands of more housing starts to help alleviate the housing crisis that's holding back our economy. It means tackling the current challenges in commercial real estate with something novel, facts and data. Hundreds more households gaining access to online social services, education, financial literacy, and medical needs, helping our healthcare providers obtain the support and resources they need to continue to thrive, embracing a clean energy transition, and advancing both multi-billion dollar transmission projects that are going to be factored here in Westchester, as well as more discrete local projects, while simultaneously recognizing the need for climate resiliency. All of this work to build a stronger, inclusive economy, all of you here tonight coming together with your support and your commitment to the WCA, each one of you is a part of this work. Now, I'm going to paraphrase George Orwell, because even in a room of equals, for tonight at least, some are more equal than others. So we have some awards to hand out. And to present our first award, I'd like to call Andrew Weiss, Brad Schwartz, and Kristen Motel to come up to the podium. Thank you.
Thank you, Michael. Good evening, everyone. Nice to see so many familiar faces. As many of you may recall, at last year's gala, Brad Schwartz and I, as co-chairs, formally announced the launch of the New Leaders Roundtable at the WCA. Now, in its second year, I'm pleased to say that this initiative is fully underway in ensuring that the priorities of Westchester's emerging leaders are reflected in the work of the WCA and advanced throughout the region. Comprised of 20 outstanding individuals, our roundtable in just the last year has been busy holding an intimate fireside chat with Deputy County Executive Ken Jenkins, hosting a Young Leaders cocktail party at the Capitol Theater, and furthering our partnership with local community organizations. At the same time, our roundtable has the distinct pleasure of selecting the annual recipient of the Trailblazer Award. This honor recognizes an accomplished young leader who embodies the roundtable's vision of impact-driven leadership focused on improving both the regional economy and community vitality. We are proud to have last year's honoree, Kristen Motel of Cuddy and Fader, on stage with us tonight to assist in the award presentation, and I will now hand it over to Brad Schwartz to present the honor.
Thank you, Andrew, and good evening, everyone. So we are excited to honor one of our own roundtable members, Meg Lander, with the New Leader Trailblazer Award. Meg is certainly highly deserving of this recognition. Meg is the Director of External Affairs for Crown Castle throughout New York and New England. Meg's work on communications infrastructure is putting Westchester at the forefront of the latest tech innovations and ensuring that kids have access to technology that they wouldn't otherwise have. Beginning with Meg's prior role as the regional director for U.S. Senate Majority Leader Chuck Schumer, Meg has dedicated her professional life to assisting Westchester's businesses, nonprofits, and residents. Over the past year, Meg was instrumental in the success of WCA's Connect Westchester Digital Equity Initiative. I got that. Got that right, Meg? And she helped launch the county's first and only digital connectivity conference. And earlier this year, Meg joined our roundtable, where she has been a valuable contributor and is already helping us plan events for 2025. So we are all honored, Meg, to recognize you for your accomplishments, and we invite you up to the stage to receive your honor.
Song to walk up to. Thank you, Brad, Andrew, and Kristen for that incredible and kind introduction, and for all that you do to lift up the next generation. And good evening, everyone. What a wonderful night to be in Westchester, and what an honor it is to receive this award. Every day, I'm fortunate to work with people who don't just think about the future, they build it. Day by day, piece by piece. A common theme throughout my career, first with Congress, with Senator Schumer, and now at Crown Castle, is that progress doesn't happen in isolation. It takes vision, collaboration, and a whole ton of grit. We've all seen how one person saying no can totally tank an entire project or idea. But tonight, we're here to celebrate those who dare to say yes. Those who, through the WCA, share a vision for the future that's bigger than themselves or their organization. In tumultuous times, where the only constant seems to be change, leadership isn't always easy. We have to balance the big picture with the small details and staying connected to people on the ground who do the work. That's why I'm so proud to be part of the WCA. Together, we don't just react to challenges, we anticipate them and we build solutions, much like our work at Crown Castle every single day. WCA programs like Connect Westchester and the Healthcare Talent Pipeline and the new Leaders Roundtable are perfect examples. Filling workforce gaps while giving people the training and opportunities they need to build a better life. And I've seen that firsthand, how life-changing these kinds of opportunities can be. My mom started her career in an entry-level role at a Westchester-based energy company. Through hard work and that company's investment in her education, she rose to the executive suite. Her story is a testament to what happens when we say yes to giving people a chance. And I'm grateful to my colleagues and my mentors in this room tonight who have done just that for me. To Anna Rua from Crown Castle, who welcomed me into an industry I knew minimal things about. To Garrett Armwood from Senator Schumer's office, our deputy state director formerly, who's now at SL Green, somewhere in the room. To Michael Romita, who invited me to be part of the board, and Chris Fisher and Robin White at the County Association who lead our digital committee. And especially to my dad, who I see in the back, who I haven't said hello to yet, who's here tonight, a retired New York City fireman who's always taught me to be a better person. You've all taught me that now more than ever, we need to actively engage young people early and meet them where they are. One of my favorite political science articles, Bowling Alone, is about the decline of civic engagement in communities. And now today, I believe we're facing a new challenge, scrolling alone. If we want young people to care about our communities, we need to show them why. Why does engagement matter? And how they can be part of the solution to be the leaders we're going to need tomorrow. I imagine a student from Yonkers logging onto the internet for the first time through Connect Westchester. Maybe they attend the WCA's new digital conference, discover a passion for technology, and eventually go to college through the PACE CyberCorps program. That's what this is all about, creating pathways for people to thrive and building a foundation for the future. Whether it's addressing housing, clean energy, or creating equitable access to healthcare and technology, we've got to do this work from the ground up by talking to people, understanding their needs, and building solutions that last. Because ultimately, our actions today are for the benefit of the next generation. By empowering young people, by believing in them, and giving them the tools needed to advance the work we've already begun, that same student from Yonkers I mentioned earlier, they'll be the one on this stage one day. And this award will be about giving back to the community and hoping to inspire the next generation to come. Thank you.
Thanks, Meg, and thanks Meg's dad. Where's Meg's dad in the back? All right, Meg's dad, come on. Now, I'd like to invite to the podium for our next award to present, is it Bill or is it Chris Fisher? It's Chris Fisher and Ashish Arora for our first leadership award. No, are we out of order? Who's next, Melissa? Bill's next, Bill Cuddy, come on up. Bill Cuddy, who heads our real estate task force, is going to present the next award. Thanks.
Thanks, Mike. All right. Meg, congratulations. That really was spectacular. Developing in Westchester County is so hard. But I don't have to tell you that. It has this incredible ecosystem, attorneys, planning and zoning, banks, unions, pick it. But nothing happens without a developer. Jonathan Gertman and his team have been one of the most innovative, creative developers in Westchester County that we've seen. NRP is the is 30 years in business. Year after year, they're recognized as one of the top 10 developers in the country. They've built over 50,000 units. The accolades go on and on. But as a national firm coming to Westchester and now delivering three major projects and hopefully more in the pipeline, you're welcome here and what we can do with the County Association to continue to support you in bringing on housing and particularly more affordable housing, we're here to do that. So Jonathan, come on up. We want to give you an award for this. Now, Jonathan's not only the senior VP in charge, and he can tell you about a couple of his projects, but he also is building out his own portfolio. His wife is expecting their first child in January.
Thank you. It's an honor enough just to get introduced by the legend Bill Cuddy. So thank you so much for that warm introduction. Congratulations to my other fellow awardees, Meg. Your wise and inspired words about the power and importance of yes is just so spot on. I'll be very brief. I'm really honored to have accepted this award on behalf of the company and my talented colleagues, many of whom are here, and I hope you all get a chance to meet them because they're pretty awesome. As Bill mentioned, and some of you know very intimately, development is a hard, complicated, risky, and with any luck, hopefully a rewarding undertaking. In New York and Westchester County in particular, it's difficult for both good and very often inexplicable reasons. But for NRP, partnerships have really been at the core of our strategy and to the extent we've had success, at the core of our success here in Westchester. That has meant collaborating with the WCA, and its common sense, solution-oriented approach to promoting healthy growth and making growth a good word, not a four-letter word, and understanding why it's so important. And I'm really particularly thankful to Mike Romita for his leadership and his friendship. It has meant leaning on experienced consultants, advisors with deep roots in the community. It's meant crafting win-win outcomes for ourselves and the communities in which we build, and creative is a very complimentary word that I really appreciate. We do try to be creative. And it's meant persevering alongside really deeply trusted partners, including the RPW Group, Forward Thinkers Development, Grandview Development. Their confidence in us has truly made all the difference. So thank you very much, and I look forward to continuing our work alongside all of you.
Thank you, Jonathan. I hope you weren't outed with that first child coming, but welcome soon to the world of those of us who sleep with one eye open for the rest of our lives. And now I'm going to welcome Chris Fisher and Ashish Arora to the stage to present our next award.
Ashish, have you seen all the influential and glamorous people that are here tonight?
Yeah, feels a bit like an Oscars. One where we have the privilege of introducing Justin Driscoll and the New York Power Authority as a WCA leadership honoree.
And Ashish, did you know that NYPA was created 90 years ago, and it's the nation's largest state-owned electric utility? And Justin's got a $3 billion annual budget?
Yes, the Power Authority has been around longer than WCA's 75 years. It originated to harness economic power from the state's water resources, including Niagara Falls, the St. Lawrence Seaway, and the Erie Canal System. Now, it is the largest state-owned power organization with 16 generating facilities and over more than 1,400 miles of transmission lines.
Wow.
I know a lot, right?
NYPA has certainly grown beyond water. Did you know the Power Authority once owned Indian Point Nuclear as well? And for the past 50 years, they've been critical to the development and financing of all types of energy infrastructure projects to get power to mass transit, the ports, and businesses across the state.
That's right. And just last year, the authority unveiled Vision 2030 with the goal to preserve hydropower, decarbonize gas power plants, and reimagine the canal system, developing new renewable energy projects with public-private partnerships.
And NYPA's high-tech, too. They partnered with New York State Connect All to leverage their own transmission and distribution infrastructure. They've brought broadband to rural communities in upstate New York. And the authority's reimagining its own operations through the power of digitization, connectivity, analytics, and AI.
That's a lot of power and tech. And NYPA's Vision 2030 strategic priorities support thriving, resilient New York State powered by clean energy, delivering economic growth for New Yorkers.
You know, Ashish, the more I think about it, NYPA's got a pretty significant mission, and they've got 2,500 employees. Are they some kind of like Marvel superhero operation over there? Are they SHIELD with energy Avengers fighting for New Yorkers?
You know, they are talking about selling their existing building in White Plains and developing new headquarters, right?
Wow, yeah. Do you think they're planning some kind of Stark Industry towers over there? Some base of operations right in our backyard?
Wait, would that make the CEO, Justin Driscoll, the Iron Man?
Whoa! Do you think Justin's gotten the state to secretly fund NextTech research as part of their own generation facilities, thousands of miles of high voltage transmission and connections to the grid?
Look, I think the bigger question is, does NYPA have Jarvis? I could use one in my car, the next Jarvis.
Exactly, I hope they're working on that. I do know through Justin's leadership, the Power Authority is helping Governor Hochul meet nation-leading clean energy goals and a dramatic transformation of the state's grid.
And before NYPA, Justin was a highly accomplished and skilled lawyer with impressive Fortune 500 connections.
He also serves on a number of influential boards, including the Alliance to Save Energy, NYSERDA, GridWise, Urban Green Council, and the World Resources Institute Global Energy Advisory.
Maybe he is just like Tony Stark. Chris, do you think there is room for a banker and a lawyer to be a NYPA Avenger?
I don't know. You know, Bank of America is a time titan company.
You sure are a super lawyer.
I think we should find out. Justin Iron Man Driscoll, please join us to accept this award if you would.
Well, good evening. Thank you, Chris, Ashish. That was some introduction. I can't say I've ever experienced that before. Hopefully this isn't recorded and there are no reporters here. But you've created quite a job for me here now going forward, and I hope I can live up to how you've described our work. But no, thank you all for this great honor. On behalf of the employees of the Power Authority and personally, as a 40-plus year resident of Westchester County, it means a lot to me to be recognized by this group. I spent many years here as a young lawyer with my colleague Kevin Plunkett, working the room at all these events over the years, and I'm just proud to be getting the award for the Power Authority, and so thank you. Thank you. As you already heard about our work, we're based here in White Plains, and from our little office at 123 Main Street. People always make fun of us when we report our address as 123 Main Street. They think it's some kind of coded address where we don't want people to know, you know, where we actually are located. But we are located at 123 Main Street, but not for much longer, as was indicated. We're in the early stages of planning a relocation across the street to the Hamilton Green location. To friends of mine who aren't that familiar with White Plains, I say, you remember the old DMV place, right? And everybody says, oh yeah, I remember. I remember the old DMV. But we're working closely with the RXR folks and Capelli, and we're looking forward to hopefully bringing that to fruition. As they say on Wall Street, we're long on Westchester County and long on White Plains, so we're thrilled to be staying here and looking forward to working with Mayor Roach to bring that to closure. So from White Plains, we supply about 25% of all electricity that's consumed on any given day in New York State, and as was said, we operate. We're the largest owner and operator of the high voltage transmission system, so we move power throughout the state from our generating facilities, the largest of which is at Niagara Falls, which is the second largest hydro facility in the United States, so we're very proud of that and welcome any of you who would like to take us up on a visit to any of our power plants. We're proud of our facilities and the work we do. Another aspect of our business is the work we do for customers around the state, and as was also mentioned, our power supplies the subways, the airports, the New York City Housing Authority, and all governmental buildings throughout New York City. But maybe most importantly, we serve municipalities all around the state, including 103 municipalities here in Westchester County that consists of towns, fire stations, school districts. And it's some of the most rewarding work that we do working with these smaller customers, and we provide energy and energy services and so forth for those customers. We're leading the state's clean energy transition on behalf of the Hochul administration. It's hard work. There'll be stops and starts along the way, but we're fully committed to the clean energy economy that we look to in the future, and we're really playing a leading role in that. So. Thank you again for this honor on behalf of the Power Authority and our employees. And again, it means a lot to me personally to be receiving this award. So thank you very much.
Thanks, Justin. Giving Anne Hathaway, James Franco, I'm just going to leave it at that. Not quite sure where I want to go from here, but we do have one more award to give out, and that's our special Al Del Bello Visionary Award. This is a special award to the Westchester County Association because Al is a past board chair of the WCA. In addition to that, he had an incredibly distinguished political career serving as lieutenant governor of the state of New York, as well as the Westchester County executive. To honor Al's legacy, we created this award in his name to be given to a deserving business leader who carries out his career-spanning vision of making our community better and more viable. Recent past recipients include some of the folks in this room, Bill Harrington, Robert Weiss, and Jane Solnick. What makes this event even more special is that it is usually presented each year by Al's widow, Dee. Unfortunately, Dee is not feeling well, so she decided it was not good for her to be spending her time in a room with 400 people. So in her place and in her stead to present this award is Michael Peck, the president of Westfair, as well as Dean Horace Anderson of the Pace University Elizabeth Haub School of Law.
Good evening. As Mike mentioned, our founder and owner, Dee, is not able to join us tonight. She's not feeling well, but she extends her warm wishes to Mike, the WCA team, and all business colleagues gathered here tonight. And she certainly regrets not being able to share the celebration and join in honoring John Noland. She also wanted me to tell Mike and everyone here, this is the first WCA gala she's missed in decades. So lest anyone out there thinks she's missed other galas, not true. So again, thank you, Michael, and thank you to the WCA for keeping Al's memory alive and perpetuating his legacy over these many years. Al has had an incredibly distinguished political career, serving as Lieutenant Governor of the State of New York, Mayor of the City of Yonkers, and Westchester County Executive. In each position, he initiated vital change and improvements. He not only had a vision, he had the capability of creating and executing those visionary ideas. Most importantly to the WCA, Al served as the chair and led the way in groundbreaking healthcare, economic development, and political advocacy initiatives. To honor Al's legacy, the WCA created an award in his name to be given to a deserving leader who carries out his career-spanning vision of making our community better and more viable.
I'm honored to be here tonight to participate in presenting the Al Del Bello Visionary Award to a distinguished, really legendary professor at the Elizabeth Haub School of Law, Professor John Noland. Professor Noland founded the law school's nationally renowned Land Use Law Center in 1993, establishing a transformative resource dedicated to building sustainable communities and regions. The center is a pioneer in promoting innovative land use strategies and collaborative decision making, offering essential training, research, education, and technical assistance programs. Serving as a vital resource, it supports local governments, community and civic leaders, students, practitioners, and academics nationwide, shaping the future of sustainable land use best practices. Through his leadership, his scholarship, and his advocacy, John has created a remarkable legacy in the field. And this legacy extends across the globe through the mentorship and knowledge that he has imparted to thousands of students over his career. A number of our students and alumni are here with us tonight. Can I hear from you? And they will attest to the impact that John has made, not only in the field of environmental law and sustainable development, but in the trajectory of their individual careers. Now, if you talk to John, he'll tell you that he shares his legacy with Al Del Bello. And that makes this award even more meaningful. John worked with Al for over three decades as his deputy director of development when Al was mayor of Yonkers, as his housing consultant when Al was county executive, and as his partner in the work of President Carter's development choices for the 1980s when Al was lieutenant governor. John will tell you that much of what he has done as the founder and a leader in our Land Use Law Center was informed and inspired by what he learned from their many shared experiences. The Land Use Law Center will be hosting its 23rd annual Alfred B. Del Bello Land Use and Sustainable Development Conference next month. As a tribute to Al's legacy, we are grateful to the Del Bello family for their support over the years. Now I'm gonna go off book just for a moment. My team doesn't like when they see me do this, but it usually works out well. I have to add a little bit to my prepared remarks because when I think about John Nolan, I think about 20 years ago being a brand new law professor at Pace Law School and learning from John just how important it was and how beautiful it was to get students connected to the world outside the classroom while they were still in school and to have them serve as a resource for the community around them. John called it back then engaged learning. Do you remember that, John? And even though we don't always still call it that, that is exactly what we practice at Pace to this very day. We're teaching in the classroom, but we're also connecting the classroom to the world outside and having our students be of service to the community. And like I said, I learned that from John. So thank you, John. And on that note, it is my privilege, my absolute privilege, to invite Professor John Nolan up to the stage to receive the Al Del Bello Visionary Award.
John F. Kennedy invited all the living Nobel laureates in the United States to have dinner at the White House. I think I caught whatever D. DeBello didn't want to catch. And he toasted them and he said, "I don't believe there's been this quantity of creativity and inspiration and just sheer brain power in the White House having dinner since Thomas Jefferson ate here alone." And I feel that way about Al Del Bello. He and his wife, Dee, did so much for this county and area. And Dee published all of our work on smart growth. We didn't call it smart growth when Al and I worked together. But what smart growth became, this eclectic, to use Michael's term, this eclectic approach to development, bringing all power, all people together who have an interest, a stake in the outcome. Al Del Bello did that since he was mayor 30, 40 years ago. So I wonder how the decision was made to honor me, but I'm so glad that I had all of those associations with Al Del Bello to get the Al Del Bello Visionary Award. As Dean Anderson, who should get a leadership award for all he's done for the law school as our dean, keeping our status as number one environmental law school in the country. We're so indebted to him. But as he pointed out, the interconnections with Al, we have kept those lessons, those visions alive through the Land Use Law Center. And Jessica Basher is here tonight, our executive director, and she will attest that things that we were doing in Yonkers 40 years ago, we're doing through smart growth in our shop at the law school. Al had a tremendous impact, not only on me, but on our family. Our daughter, Jenny, was a law student 15 years ago, and she showed up all dressed up one afternoon. And I said, honey, where are you going? What are you doing? She said, I'm going to go to the Yonkers Zoning Board of Appeals meeting. I said, why would you do that? What is on the agenda that you're interested in? And she said, Al DiBello. I said, what do you mean? She said, well, I've seen him. I've worked in Yonkers, and I've seen him. And he teaches me so much about lawyering. He's got two clients. He's aggressively explaining the benefits of their project to the Zoning Board of Appeals. And he respects the volunteer board members. And he shows that respect. And he listens to the neighbors. And he considers their objections. And for me, this is a new type of lawyering that Al DiBello is teaching me. Now, Jenny, tomorrow morning, will walk into the classroom. She's a adjunct professor, staff attorney, and she's teaching 50 students tomorrow morning, and she brings the Al DiBello approach to creating a new generation of lawyers, in my opinion. And then 50 years ago, harking back to 50 years ago, Al DiBello walked into my wife's office. Anne is here tonight, and she was a beginning health planner in the county health department. He said, Anne, the Reverend Jeanette Phillips has asked us to help her on behalf of the American African-American community of Peekskill to help them with the fledgling community health center that they're putting together. And they want a contribution from the county. And I thought our best contribution would be you and your vision and your understanding of community health and your passion for ample and accessible health care for everyone. And Anne was given a temporary assignment to work with the Peekskill Area Health Center. And now, 50 years later, she's still there. Only they changed the name to Sun River Health. And they have 50 sites throughout the metropolitan region. And they have over 200,000 patients. And Al and I talk about Al DiBello all the time because he has such a strong, unbelievably strong effect on all of us. So I don't know how the selection committee knew all those connections, but from the perspective of understanding Al DiBello's leadership, his vision, we're very honored, very, very honored to receive this award. Thank you, Michael Romita. Thank you, the board of WCA and your selection committee. You might have made a mistake, but I'm claiming it.
Don't go away, John. So if you read John's professional CV, he makes this big deal about this society he was in law school called the Barristers, which was like a Phi Beta Kappa type award. John and I went to the same law school. I too was a barrister, but the Barristers that I remember was a secret drinking club. So I don't know what the mileage he's getting out of this barrister's thing, but I gotta throw some stuff up on my professional CV and take advantage of that as well. Now, whether or not you are more in the John Barrister or the Michael Romita Barrister, I hope you'll join us back downstairs for some intellectual conversation and booze. Thank you. Enjoy the rest of your evening.